Good morning, people. My initial plan for today was to wake up at 5 a.m. and go to this Nepenthes drop to proxy a pair for a good friend of mine in LA. Apparently, people are already camping outside since like 9 p.m. last night, so I got the text at 5 a.m. and my friends who were already there, they hit me up. They're like, it's like 20 people deep. And I was like, fuck, I don't think it's even worth going. So I just slept in. But basically, this drop was a collaboration with ASAP Rocky. I believe they did a collaboration before with the tracksuits and all these different colorways. I'm not a huge Needles fan. I really don't wear any Needles, so there was really no point of me going. But yeah, today's vlog is basically another
day in my life on the weekend in Tokyo.
I'm going to Shibuya today, which I absolutely hate because it's so crowded on the weekends. But there's apparently a store that my friends really want to go, Mackie and Giz. They're like, hey, come through. There's a store that we want to check out. So be at Shibuya by 11:45 or whenever the fuck. So yeah, that's pretty much my plan. Enjoy the video. Also, Mackie just recommended this song to me. It's called Old Town Road by Lil Nas X. Apparently, it's a mix between hip-hop and country music, but that's fucking insane. I don't know what song it was, but apparently it broke the record for the most streamed song on Spotify. And apparently beat Drake's record by a mile, so I'm gonna check it out. That's trippy as fuck. It's so hot today. Beautiful weather though. Pretty cool. Just having some coffee right now. What I'm wearing is Issey Miyake pleats, Uniqlo tee, Rick Owens trousers, Common Projects, of course, if you don't know already, the best. Funny thing about Common Projects is that I always double up on a pair because one, I use it for the nighttime, one, I use it for the daytime, and the other one's fucking beat. One night out, it's done. Like, it gets trashed and I always need a second pair to, like, you know, wear it fresh, keep it clean, invest in a pair. For your information, this place has the best fried chicken. Karaage, which is a Japanese way of doing fried chicken, is basically thighs. God, I hate Shibuya. Just look at how many people there are. Just look. Just take it in. That dog over there. Apparently the owner of a dog died and the dog waited at that spot for 9 years straight and just passed away there, so it's very monumental. Now they call it Hachiko something, I forgot, but it's a common meetup spot, a hot spot so to speak. This is exactly why I ate Shibuya. This is exactly why. Just look. I mean, sure, if you're a tourist, definitely come here for like maybe a day or two, but after that, bro, you get sick of it. It's basically like Times Square in New York. It's just way too hectic to be around, and people are just like dickheads. So basically people come here to take photos right at the center of the spot. It's a very common place to take pictures, and they just post it on Instagram to look basic as fuck and let everyone know that they're in Tokyo. It's just doing exactly what I was telling you guys about, you know? Over here too. Over there too. Yes, it is a tradition to take a picture out here in Shibuya. We got Gizmo the goat, Mackie on the move. Let's see what you caught, bro. It's the one I wanted. You scooped it. Scooped it right up.
Jack your swag.
Fuck you.
Yeah, let's get
this. Can I see your jacket?
Yes.
Dude, the teal is sick. With the orange.
And Mackie's gonna jack my swag again.
Is this a new collection?
Yeah.
No, it's not the new collection. It's the one they released, 19SS.
Oh, sick. So this store is called Waremoku. Don't know what they have here, but let's go check it out. Sick. So what do you do out here, bro?
Oh, this is Q, aka... Just give me your full name, bro.
Mason Quincy Avena.
That's fucking fire.
This is the new Kigo collection from 19, spring summer collection. Pretty sick with the teal job. I'm guessing they got the inspo from
Japanese uniforms beyond point.
Wow, look at this. It's not my vibe, but the way it's constructed is so weird. What the fuck? Inner ankle protection. It's wavy actually. We'll never wear it though. That's just me though. Pretty cool store, check it out. It's called Waku Mode, or whatever what it's called.
Medium large.
Y'all are on the Kiko wave.
You can go to great.
I can try the L first.
Come on, I'm wearing an L.
What are you wearing?
I don't know.
Let's get the pants here and then get the jacket over there.
Can I try the pants? Kiko Essex pants.
This is the 2019 spring summer collection,
yeah.
Right?
New one. Same as kids.
Y'all are Kiko'd out, and I'm here just. My basic shit. Oh, that's not bad at all. $100.
Very cool store. Definitely worth a visit, actually.
Mackie.
See, the Kiko A6.
Crease.
Oh, you already. You fucking idiot. The Kiko trousers, as well as the Needles hoodie.
Looking real. Real wavy out here, Mackie.
Cozy.
Gonna be famous in less than 3 years. Trust me.
Cut out the trees.
He's famous now, in
He's
my
famous
books.
Now, for real. Exactly, that's what I'm saying.
We are at Harajuku.
Which, honestly, I've been hating recently too, just because of the people here. It's way too fucking crowded. Imagine what 2020 is gonna be like. It's double the amount, yeah, for sure.
The fuck, the water just fell.
It's okay,
the water just fell.
Rainproof gear. That's why you're wearing Kikos.
Nah, this is not Loro Piana. it's not the Loro Piana one.
The Loro Piana goes for like racks, huh?
The retail, yeah.
Pulling up to Great, which is another pretty popular, probably the most popular store.
It's the best.
Look at the vibe here. Have this whole Japanese aesthetic going on with the trees, with the little bonsais. So what are your thoughts on Palm Angels, bro?
Well, it's highly overpriced, and the quality is so-so. But this brand right here...
Fire, he's going crazy.
Yep, shout out Mao. Tokyo Great job only. With the, honestly, made in Japan only. Fire. You see J Balvin's account and Billie Eilish's account? They both wore it too, as well as Tyga, I believe. So check out Mao's Instagram, it's called Mavericks_T. Very good friend of ours. Support the locals. Let's see how much this ridiculous shit is. 5 racks. Easy. Whatever. Light work.
Fine.
Light work.
Fine. All in a day's work.
Especially for Mackie, light work, right?
Huh?
Oh. Followings here. Cold following.
They always have like the same followings.
Yeah.
Like Jerry Lorenzo.
Yeah.
Virgil, Harry Preston.
Like diehard fans too. I've never been in a place where they have like, no matter what they're dropping or what it is, like even if it doesn't look good, like it'll sell out. Like,
honestly.
It's so crazy here.
I call it the Bari effect. They always try to duplicate like what Bari's wearing.
Right.
Literally just carbon copy
and
everything.
As long as it's seen by somebody else and they'll recognize it, they don't care.
Facts.
I don't care if it actually looks good.
Facts.
Or it fits their personal style like at all. Personal style has gone away. It's just
honestly,
branding now.
Honestly. Dude, that's what I'm saying. That's my whole YouTube channel is about.
Really?
It's just having personal style. I'm not following this like trend.
Yeah. My biggest thing is like I don't really like necessarily care about like clothing brands. I care about like the people that make them, like honestly.
Like friends.
Yeah, friends here
I
that are doing
that
shit. Like I want them to succeed. Not like some person that I don't really know.
No.
But just because they're popular, like everybody's buying that shit. Like I don't know.
Right.
What people don't understand is like those people like made it because they were supporting each other, and instead of like people supporting each other, they want to like go with whatever's
big.
Whatever
is big.
Yeah.
Straight facts.
You have to look at the camera.
Yeah, let's see.
That's so cute. That's
bro.
Hey, I need to remove the price tag.
Lucky you're a fake copper.
I'm gonna cop it anyway, right?
Give me a runway walk.
You gotta go. You gotta put on the.
You can't smile too. You have to have a straight.
So
You have to look fierce. You have to just like look straight.
I can look down.
Hey, you might be a potential model for Kiko, so you have to qualify for this. Let's go.
Wait, stop, go back.
We're just at Trunk Hotel now. It's way too fucking hot. Just getting a quick tan, right, Giz? But yeah, not a good day to vlog. Just pulling up to this farmer's market that occurs every weekend, I believe. But they just have these like small vendors that. I don't know, just check it out. Good food, good vibes. You know, organic, healthy vibe.
Windy as hell, son. You like food or fashion?
Food!
No, for real. Oh, okay. We're all on the same page here then.
I like meat though. I like meat.
Fresh produce. We've got dried fruits. I don't know what the fuck that is. Oh, coffee. That's the shit. Now we're talking. I love coffee. Brokkoli desu ka?
Brokkoli.
Oh my god. Pickles, bro. Let's go find.
Actually, I threw away the sample.
You did?
Yeah.
How?
I don't know.
Oh, there they are. What is that?
It's like a pepper oil. You guys should try it.
Try it, Mackie.
Try it. It's so good.
Try that one.
Eat it.
Everything. With the pepper.
Yeah.
There you go. How is it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Scared the shit out of me.
Thank you.
That's the pepper oil, right?
Maybe it's just different from car to car.
Show us what you bought at the farmer's market, Farrell.
I can't show you because I don't own it.
Oh my god.
Oil infused with pepper and many spices.
Only exclusive to farmer's market.
Very delicious.
Is this what is that? That's the pepper.
Break pepper. And look at the design, like the Spider-Man.
So you, oh wow.
Ooh. Yeah, there's pepper broken. Yeah.
I almost bought the wrong one.
So what do you eat that with?
Rice, anything. Pasta, chicken.
Soka.
Actually, you're gonna break anything. Your teeth, maybe, if you eat the unbroken one.
Shut the fuck up. Why would you break your teeth? It's already broken.
No, I mean if you bought the...
Hot
the heel.
And this one, you eat it with like chips?
We have to...
Maybe. It's my
first
time getting this one.
We have to think about that one.
We're trying to eat
have you tried it?
Just there.
Just a sample.
This
is the first time we're buying.
Fire.
Most people say they made with Japanese ingredients only, and that's not really attractive actually.
Fukushima?
Orange?
Cheese with like mikan probably? Or orange? I don't know. It says... It's wheat, butter, some, I guess.
Almond, what?
Almond.
Poodle.
Almond poodle.
We gotta hit that spot.
I think that's the goal, right? Just hitting every ugly delicious spot out in Tokyo.
But we got stuck in Savoy.
Yeah, Savoy just trapped us. Honestly, yes. That place is literally probably stuck. The best pizza I'll ever have.
Yes.
I had best pizza last night.
Guess we're headed to. Again! Yay!
Capital.
Everyone loves Capital. They want to see Capital though. Because it's only available here. Back home.
It's too soft.
It's like kind of fragile, huh? It literally is a Kiko clutch bag, but it's just bandana material, right? It's just, I don't know, it's just too like fragile. I don't think you can't put heavy things in it.
Just like put like power bank.
Yeah. Wow. So thin. Africa denim. That's cool. ASAP Rocky vibe. Oh shit.
Wow.
Oh, it's literally a dickhead. You put it on your dick. No, not your dick. You put it on your head to look like a dick. That's why a dickhead, Mr. D.
AKA Ken.
That's a real flex. Did you say AKA Ken?
Yeah.
Fuck you. That's a pair of denim. Size 100. Is this for sale?
No. That's the one place.
Are you copying this shirt?
I'm copying the yellow kimono.
The yellow kimono?
Yeah.
I think it's a first watch.
And then this watch, right? Cool.
What's good? So I'm gonna be going to Seoul for 2 weeks because in Japan there's this thing called Golden Week. If you're a working salaryman or if you work in corporate, the national policy is that these people need to stop working for 2 weeks during the year because generally speaking, Japan is a very overworking society. I'm gonna be going to Seoul for 2 weeks to see my mom, to see my beautiful dogs, and my girlfriend who's gonna be there, so I'm very excited for that. But I'm gonna show you guys exactly what I'm gonna be packing for Seoul. Honestly, I'm not gonna be packing too many things because I already have a lot of my shit back in Seoul. I have 2 pairs of Tom Sacks, a Louis Vuitton bag, and a couple other like vintage tees and basic shit like that. So let's get it started, shall we? I'm gonna be wearing a lot of white sneakers. The first thing I'm gonna be packing, Common Projects, which I absolutely adore. Actually, I'm gonna put it here. I'm gonna also be bringing these 85 Jordans. I think it's a great summer shoe. All white, neutral colorway. I like that vintage look as well. You can just rock it with a pair of shorts, a vintage tee, and Jordans would do just fine, I believe. I'm also gonna be bringing these white Vans that they did a collaboration with Justin Saunders. I don't know the secret of keeping them clean. I had it over like a year or so now. And I guess you just have to be a little bit more cautious or do like a bi-weekly shoe clean, if you know what I mean. It has like a very cool green sheen to it in the sunlight, but it also has like that earth tone vibes to it. So Marie Kondo has her show on Netflix on how to clean your house and how to better organize your wardrobe and like your entire house pretty much. There's a little known trick that my mom has taught me when I was a kid. Instead of folding your clothes, you roll them because you save a lot more space and they don't crease. There you go. I'm also gonna be bringing these light wash indigo denim from Acne Studios. This is the Max LT Prince. I think this came out like 5-6 years ago. It was highly slept on, man. The wash is insane too. Look at it, vintage vibes. And it fits great on your body. These are my everyday trousers that I wear on a day-to-day basis. I will also be bringing them because they're comfortable as fuck. And for shorts, I'll be bringing these. These are the Nike Matthew Williams collab that they did last year. I was lucky enough to get a pair for retail at United Arrows and Sun. So shout out, what was his name again? Whoever you are, shout out to you. I didn't even have to like line up or camp up for this. So thank you for hooking me up for retail. For tees, I'll be bringing this Wu-Tang, Casuals, everything around me. Obviously, 36 Chambers, the best album that they ever put out. Honestly, dude, like, I don't wear vintage tees for the sole purpose of wearing vintage tees. I actually can relate to the music they produce, as well as if I ever walk into a bar and the bartender are playing like Wu-Tang and rap music, I can always have a conversation about Wu-Tang with them. So very good prop for starting conversations with strangers, I guess. I believe I showed this in my previous video, as well as the Wu-Tang tee, but this is another vintage tee that I absolutely love. I used to skate a lot back in middle school, and Sonic Youth was one of the bands that I really fucked with. If I'm not where I am today, I probably would have been an aspiring professional skateboarder. As weird as that sounds, it really created a culture back in Seoul where culture was literally lacking. Very sentimental piece to me, and I wear this a lot. This is also gonna be brought with me. I honestly don't know what this tee is, but I got this from my mom, and she knew that I really liked vintage tees, and she likes simple shit like this, so... yeah, she definitely has better taste than me, huh? Just a basic blank black tee that I can wear inside out, or just like this. Very clean, very simple. I'll also be taking this with me. I wear this a lot, actually. Probably one of my favorite pieces in my closet right now is this Savoy tee. You guys know that I love their pizza, and the staff graciously hooked me up with this tee. It's only supposed to be given out to staffs and
friends and family.
This is probably my favorite t-shirt in my entire wardrobe, just because I can really represent something or someone when I wear this, because I don't know, I just have a very deep connection to this restaurant in Tokyo, so thank you. Chrome hearts, the fuckboy vibe, blank on the back. Honestly, sometimes hate wearing chrome hearts because, especially as an Asian, you just look like a complete fuckboy, so... and the rest probably will be just Uniqlo tees that I pretty much wear 24/7. Don't buy any of these, just buy these because these are probably the best fitting t-shirts ever made. Ever. For sweaters, just a simple fitted gray hoodie, as well as one of my favorite pieces in my wardrobe, the oversized, cropped, beautifully constructed hoodie. Face wash, moisturizer, toner, more moisturizer. So this is exactly what I'll be taking back to Seoul. Very minimalistic way of traveling. I didn't really pack too many things, but I do have a lot of stuff back in Seoul, and I'll make a video on that. So yeah, stay tuned for the next video. Thank you guys for watching. See you guys in Seoul.